ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, it is my pleasure to be here in this very excellent group. And after receiving very prominent professors, the lectures, I would like to turn to the practice, because I am a medical doctor and I am working at the Page Medical University as a chairman of the complementary medicine department. And I have 14 PhD students as well. My classification is the medical doctor and internal medicine, work medicine and rehabilitation. And this is the reason I was established the Yamamoto Rehabilitation Institute in Budapest 30 years ago. Of course, the complementary medicine is a quite different way, and I was a member for the Cambrella Pan-European project, which was involving 17 universities in Europe to investigate the complementary medicine and the therapies and the legalization and legislation and consumption and the usage of the different type of complementary medicine in Europe, and after that the NATO as well. The NATO was the same project to investigate in the NATO countries the complementary medicine. This is about me. I am not a biophysician, so I am a medical doctor, only I wanted to show you. I am working for some medical journals as editors, and for this is very interesting, the International Journal of the Integrative Medicine and the European Journal of Integrative Medicine, England, because it was published, our paper with BioBran in this journal. The Oncotherm journal in German and English is the other interesting topic, because we combine the BioBran therapy with the oncothermia, which is a very natural instrumental instrument without any chemotherapy. No, about the complementary medicine and alternative. Is existing alternative therapy, alternative medicine? I don't think. The medicine only one. This is unified. Has an academic medicine and a complementary medicine. This is my opinion about this. According to the European survey, we can see that a lot of people are using complementary medicine in the cancer patients, and the CAM is increasing to ability and to elevate the ability to fight cancer or improve the physical and emotional well-being. This is the most important. According to the classification of the complementary medicine, we can see they are the mind and body medicine, especially the yoga is very useful for the cancer patients, the biological-based practice, and the aromatherapy, nutrition, herbal teas, and supplements, and the BioBran belongs to this category. The manipulative therapies, the massage and reflexology, energetic medicine, whole medical system. The whole medical system is the traditional Chinese medicine, acupuncture, or homeopathy, and the herbal medicine as well. It means that we have to combine the any kind of the therapy, therapeutic forms they have approving for our patients. A few years ago, I was invited to the Columbia University in New York, and I was very astonished and surprised, because I have seen such a brochures to have information for the cancer patients, the yoga, acupuncture, aromatherapy, nutrition, massage, reflexology, dietary supplements as well. And it was very, very, very nice for the patients. In the European countries, it seems to be more and more patients are turning to the complementary medicine. And we have to control it, and we have to help them, and we have to give them the correct information and correct and ethical information, the patients. For the cancer patients, it was in the lung cancer investigation, and the cause thoracodynia, hemoptysis, and the fever for the patients with lung cancer was investigation, and it was a significancy to decrease the problems with the complementary medicine. Let's go to the acupuncture, because acupuncture is a very interesting therapeutic form, not according to that ancient Chinese theory, but now we are able to prove that there is the neuroendocrine modification has, and a lot of endomorphin, dynorphin, and enkephalins and the other immunomodulant are produced much more. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved the needles as a medical device. And in the cancer treatment, we can meet the following problems. The fatigue, the nausea, vomiting after chemotherapy, anxiety, depression, and the insomnia, appetite loss, and hot flashes, especially the mama and prostate carcinoma, according to the contralateral hormone therapies, nerve problems, constipation, or diarrhea. And they are the symptoms. We have to use something. Useful or harmful? This is the question. And there are controversial publication about this. Edgar Ernst in England that didn't like the complementary medicine. He was the professor in the Bristol of the complementary medicine department. And he has some confusion with the Princess Henry. he was retired after that. But I think there is. There are the side effects due to chemotherapy, and we were able to introduce the acupuncture for these patients for these symptoms in the daily practice. This is the very nice research. It was published. The mechanical signaling through connective tissue, a mechanism from the therapeutic effect of acupuncture. It means that this is a modulation and immune modulation as well, and the neuromodulation as well. It means that the final results of the acupuncture is a very big success for the mentioned problems. The TCM doesn't mean the acupuncture, but the herbal medicine as well, and the massage therapy, and to looking the patients as a whole system. Protect the normal cells, enhance the potency of the chemoradiotherapy, prolong the life, and reduce the inflammation of the surrounding cancerous tissues. They are verified. Improve the quality of life, finally, and improve the general condition and the body resistance of the patients. The main features of the TCM involving the herbal medicine as well, in the Western perspective, are the follows. They enhance the immune function, balance the endocrine system, because the neuroendocrine system has a very close correlation to the immune system as well. The blood production promoting, protect the marrow and the function of the heart, liver, and kidney. The kidney is the father of the marrow, according to the TCM. Digestive tract, improve absorption, the metabolic function, the body self-regulation ability, and reduce the side effect. This is the TCM and homeostasis. And the homeostasis is very important because there is the nervous system, and the nervous system, according to the hypothalamus hypophyseal system as well, the set point is the 36.5, and the physiologic reaction, and this is a negative feedback, and we control everything ourselves. If there is the set point is more a little bit, it means that the body homeostasis can change it, and action for the upregulation of the treatment effect, we have to use it for the treatment as well, and this is the oncothermia as well. Everybody will have my lectures. Monica told me, okay? Please look only this one. The mechanical signaling through connective tissue, I mean, is for the therapeutic effect of acupuncture was published a few years ago. It means that if we rotate it and we make a mechanical signal, it could be involved in the different slides. We can see the mechanical signal to the fibrous sites and the other connective tissue sites, and that this mechanic sign can lead to an electromagnetic sign as well. Relationship acupuncture points and meridians to the connective tissue was a very excellent book published a few years ago. And you can see in the very, very precise slides that the needle, the top of the needle, and this is the reason why the acupuncture can make a mechanic signal towards to the neuroendocrine system. If we make acupuncture, we can follow it with a functional MRI, and we can see the limbic system and the thalamic system, the activation, if we make an acupuncture system. There are some clinical trials for the acupuncture in the cancer patients. For example, together with the vitamin B6 in the ovarian cancer and the nausea and vomiting after the chemotherapy, it was published by Karolinska Institute many, many years ago, according to after the radiotherapy as well. Now we combine the acupuncture and the BioBran and the oncothermia together. The oncothermia is the targeted oncothermia, is quite different from the whole body hyperthermia. I don't put the patients in the machine cooling the head, but with the targeted radio frequency, I am targeting only the tumor, the bad cells, and the wall of the cells. It means that the modulated radio frequency current heating. And this is the reason we nominated it as an oncothermia, not a hyperthermia. There is a radio frequency generator, and this is a water bolus in the abdomen and the back of the patients, and the patient is lying, and only the tumor could be involved. And we made with the Chinese researcher a tender, and in the Oncothermia journal we published that. What are the oncothermia results? We have the oncothermia results in the different stages and the different type of the tumors. In the liver in the liver and the metastatic liver disease, the pancreas, brain glioblastoma, lung, and so on. And oncothermia at survival benefits for all the investigation, tumor localization together with BioBran. The first one with the sarcoma, they are the most effective survival time, and the other if there is when others fall. This is the permanent acupuncture. It was developed by us in the Pécsi University. It means that the absorbable monofilaments we put in the special points of the patients. This is the carcinoma prostata with metastatic lumbar region with a osteolytic pain, and it was very painful. And there is a point according to the TCM for the vertebra, back vertebra. And the absorbable monofilaments remains there for 3 weeks, 4 weeks after that disappeared. And it means that we don't disturb the patients every 2 times a week or so. It is very excellent way, especially for the patients that they wouldn't like to have a needle every day. And this is the carcinoma ovary metastasis, and there is a point it was sensitive, and this is according to the ovary, and this is according the other points according to TCM with the permanent techniques as well. They are some evidence-based, and what is the reason for the herbal medicine and acupuncture and especially the complementary medicine, why they are useful in the different diseases? Because the hypothalamus controls the pain control, the endocrine system, the autonomic nervous system, and the neurochemical release as well. More than 40 different type of neurochemical is able to produce by such techniques as well. This is the pain control, this is the thyrotrope hormone, SCTH, ADH, sympathetic and parasympathetic, and from the sympathetic tone we are going to the parasympathetic tone. It is less stress, and we are going to help the patients, for example, to relieve the anxiety and depression and so. And the neurochemical, endorphin, dynorphin, and the other morphine they are producing. The acupuncture channel leads to the tractus spinothalamicus, to the occipital frontal, the thalamus nucleus, and there are so many different type of the results we can, together with the BioBran therapy, oncothermia, and acupuncture together. The task is the curing the disease, of course, but the cancer has no immunotherapy, unfortunately. This is the reason we have to combine with the other therapies as well, reducing suffering and achieving an acceptable quality of life of the patients. But if the patient's in the final stage, we have to have a honesty and the compassion. They are very essential. There are some misunderstandings, the communication deficiencies, and the conflict between the raising false hopes. We mustn't give a false hope for the patients as well. No, this is the paper we perform, and many thanks for DIVA Corporation for helping us. It was published in the European Journal of Integrative Medicine last year, the controlled pilot study for cancer patients suffering from chronic fatigue syndrome due to chemotherapy treated with BioBran. And with my colleagues, they are PhD students of my department, and we published that. The protocol was 50 patients. First, we involved 60 patients, but 10 was excluded for different reasons, no cooperation and the other reason. And finally, 25 was treated and 25 for the control. They received chemotherapy, acupuncture, oncothermia, and BioBran, 3 grams per day. And the periods of course was 3 months and plus 1 and plus 3 months follow-up time. And additionally, we applied the butterfly acupuncture. Butterfly acupuncture is a special in the ear acupuncture, was published in the NATO for a medical doctor, Richard Nimtsov, and he developed it for the Afghanistan military reason, because if the soldiers has a bomb, an explosion, and he applied some points. There are the anxiety points and the thalamic points and the pain relieving points. And he achieved a survival, better survival time without shock to transfer the patients to the hospital. It was a very excellent. And now he is teaching the Chinese people for this method as well. No, we applied this one. And according to the protocol, we measured the quality of life and the visual analog scale for the patients. The physical function, according to the SF questionnaire, yeah, because it was mentioned previously, and each patient, we measured it, and at the end of the 4 weeks and the end of 24 weeks, you can see that it was elevated. The green one is the elevated physical function. It means that they were able to do something, to sometimes work something, and the physical activity was much, much better. But the emotional function is very interesting, because a lot of patients are suffering from depression and chronic fatigue, and they are hopeless. And we have to give some positive future for the patients. And we were able to achieve this result. The black one is the result, the emotional function after finishing the protocol. It means that before and after that the physical function, to make a similarity, this is much higher. The green one is the hair green is the end station, and the visual analog scale was able to measurement in each patient much higher. The visual analog scale according to the pain syndrome as well. Visual analog scale at the end of the 8 week. Each patient, and the visual analog scale at the end of the 24 weeks. It means the each patient, and the blue one is seems to be much higher as was previously. And altogether, everything you can analyze in your home, because I wouldn't like to share your time for this one. Emotional function, it was improvement in each patient in the emotional function after the 24 weeks. And the physical function, visual analog scale, and quality of life, and the emotional function was elevated in the patients after that. This is a very questionnaire, but interesting in the complementary medicine, the dark field microscopy. There is some sludge in the peripheric blood. And after the complex therapy, BioBran and oncothermia, we achieved this one. It means that it was the PhD changes in the patients as well. There are some summary. It means that the potential of the synergy of the high-tech OTM and the oncothermia and the TCM and the herbal medicine extremely huge. We need more investigation and more financial support maybe for make more complex trials as well. And the synergy of the ancient knowledge and the high-tech state-of-art treatments in the medical knowledge could be established. There are some publication about this topic, and the combination in as an integrative therapy in the Western medicine is necessary because we don't know a monotherapy against the cancer. The academic oncology is speaking about operation chemotherapy and radiation therapy for the holistic. The biological oncology could have a holistic balance and support of the human energy and metabolism and the immunology we are speaking about. And the psychological oncology, rebuilding of the emotional life and the connection. This is all belongs to the complexity of the treatment of the patients. Now I would like to speak about very shortly about the oncothermia. Because the oncothermia is not a new product, not because we know it from the ancient times as well. And this is the Pécsi University, Szent István University, because my professor, I was working together, Professor Sass is a professor at this university, and the Yamamoto Rehabilitation Institute, my institute in Budapest, I am working there, and the oncothermia is situated in Hungary, but the office is the Germany in Cologne. We have international cooperation as well. No, the history of the medicine is very long, yeah, more thousand years. And as a more thousand years, you can see in the first written summary of the medicine in before Christ 3000, and the surgical papyrus Edwin Smith, and the first written summary of the medicine was the Yellow Emperor in the China as well. This is the Bible of the TCM till now as well. It means that very long period, and the philosophy of the Western medicine was starting from Hippocrates. He told nil nocere and help the nature, help the nature. And the oncology, he used the hyperthermia. For example, the mama breast cancer. The philosophy of the Eastern medicine, the Lao Tse, He said, be harmonic and nature is harmonic, and use the nature, and use the herbal medicine as well. This is the thank you very much. This is the Western symbol of the complexity. This is Escher. If you can see, they are some angels and they are some devils. Yes? You can see. This is devil and this is the angel. Yeah? This is the biangular. This is the bad and good, the breast, the beauty and the best, yeah? And so, this is the Eastern symbol of the complexity, the yin and yang. It means the sympathetic, parasympathetic, man and woman, day and night, you know? This is the same one, only the approach is a little bit different. Next one, please. No, but the new science is emerging according to the topic. This is the fractal physiology, and this is the reason I was the president of the Hungarian Biophysical Association, because I was dealing with the hyperthermia as well. And they are the book they were published about this. And the hyperthermia, they are the book about the hyperthermia as well. It means that this is the latest one, the oncothermia, the principle and the practice. And this is the reason we use it, because we promote the natural process by combination of the herbal medicine, BioBran, and the electromagnetic energy in the oncology. Be non-toxic, be natural. This is the first. Parallel thinking of the herbal tradition and fractal physiology. We combine the ancient and the modern science. The healthy balance for the normal homeostasis is this one. But if the balance has a disturbance, it could be a signal of disease. It means that the torque and we achieve the imbalance. And if we need energy absorption, energy of the herbs, energy of the physical energy, we can make a balance and the forced homeostasis again. The principle of the oncothermia is that the hyperthermy is a radiative magnetic non-modulated. This is the hyperthermy. The hyperthermy has gone away because the oncothermy destroys only the bad cells, only the malignant cells. It means that there is a radiofrequency current flows through the target. The energy is carried by a modulated radiofrequency. And we made several cell culture, animal and human researches about this. Malignant cells are more active, their environment in rich ions. And this is the PT image for the metastasis. The metabolic activity is higher in cancerous cells, and the PET is able to measure the metabolic activity. This is the reason we use it for the diagnosis as well. The impedance is very important. This is a physics as well, because the conductivity of the tumor is much higher than the adipose tissue or the connective tissue in vivo and in vitro as well. Now, we made an MRI, and there is the tumor. And we make a conductance. There is the tumor. And we make an MRI after that as well. And we are able to recognize the tumor and the size of the tumor and the changing of the tumor as well. And we can measure the conductance as well of the tumor. The patient is lying between the two electrodes, the positive and the negative, and the electromagnetic waves are going on the malignant tumors only, not the health tissue. They don't destroy it, never. The focus is automatic, it does not move. There is the treated and untreated tissue, and the healthy tissue is unaffected. And there is a human immortalized keratocytes, there is the untreated and there is the treated. And there is a highly proliferating tissue in the slightly affected, but the healthy cells are intact, you can see. This is the malignant tissue. It is most important, and this is after the treatment. We made several investigations in the animals, effect of electrical field in the xenograft study, the hyperthermy in the case of hyperthermy, in the case of our investigation method, the oncothermy and the oncothermy. It means that the oncothermy 42 degrees centigrade affected only the tumor is more effective for the patients. We investigated the cell death, the hyperthermy and the oncothermy, and this is the hyperthermy and this is the oncothermy. This is quite different. This is the hyperthermy and this is the oncothermy, quite different. The cell death, we would like to achieve not the necrosis, but the apoptosis of the cells. Apoptosis in the oncothermia is more significant in the oncothermy. This is the equipment and some cases I would like to show. This is involving IA and the diagnosis. Sinus sphenoidalis inoperable tumor was the patient. And after that, after the treatment, he is symptom free. And this is a very, very, very bad situation on Hodgkin lymphoma in the woman and after the treatment as well, esophagus carcinoma. He was not able to eat, and after that, after the oncothermia and the cervix carcinoma, this is inoperable, and after that, pediatric ependymoma. Before the oncothermia and after that, the first session of the oncothermia, and this is the finishing the oncothermia. Karnofsky's score was very elevated. Liver metastasis from colorectal cancer. And it means that the oncothermia alone and the oncothermy with chemotherapy and oncothermy with chemotherapy and herbal medicine, the expected survival time is much better. Statistically significant differences are in the several more or hospitals we were working together in different hospitals with these methods, and we see that the pancreas carcinoma survival was 210% more with these methods, combined methods. Brain glioma survivors, average 107% more the survival. It means in the stomach cancer, and it means that the liver cancer, we see the significant improvement of the patient's life. They are the cooperative medical doctors and professor with us, and the take-home message after that we have to combine different type of proved therapy for achievement, the better quality of life and better survival time of the patients. This is the take-home message. Thank you very much for your audience.